Good morning children. In this lesson, we know about caste discrimination and struggle for equality. Caste system has created one of the major forms of inequality in our country. For centuries, people have fought against this discrimination and our constitution too strives to end it. Elimination of caste discrimination has been one of the major aims of our governments. Let us know how caste system works and what steps have been taken to end caste discrimination. In the caste system, communities are a group of people who are placed in social order where each caste has either above or below the other. Those who placed themselves at the top of the ladder are called themselves upper caste and saw themselves as superior. The groups of were placed at the bottom of the ladder were seen as unworthy and were called untouchables. Caste rules were set and did not allow the so-called untouchables to take on work other than what they were meant to do. For example, some groups were only allowed to pick garbage and remove dead animals from the village. But they were not allowed to enter the homes of upper caste, take water from the village well or enter the temple. Their children could not sit next to the children of their caste in schools. Thus, upper caste act in ways which did not give the so-called untouchables the same rights as they enjoyed. When some people are not allowed to do what they want to do, like get education or take up jobs of their choice, we can say that they are facing discrimination. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, chairperson of the Committee for Drafting of the Constitution of India and the first Union Law Minister of India, one of the greatest leader, shares his first examples of caste-based discrimination, which took place in 1901. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar belonged to Mahars. Mahar is one of the communities which are treated as untouchables in the Bombay Presidency. He had gone with his brothers and cousins to meet his father in Koregaon, which is now in Maharashtra. After reaching the station, there were many bullock carts plying for hire. Ambedkar and his cousins wanted to hire one bullock cart, but not one of them was prepared to suffer being polluted and to demean himself carrying the passengers of the untouchable classes. They were prepared to pay double the fare, but they found that money did not work. This small incident shows how a simple task of going from one place to another in a cart was not accessible to the children, even though they could pay the money. All the cartmen at the station refused to take the children. They acted in a discriminatory manner. So clearly, caste-based discrimination is not only limited to preventing Dalits from undertaking certain economic activities, but it also denies them the respect and dignity given to others. Another example of discrimination in schools. Om Prakash Valmiki is a famous Dalit writer. In his autobiography Jutaan, he wrote, when he was in class 4, the headmaster asked Om Prakash to sweep the school and the playground. Om Prakash was made to sweep the school and the playground for the couple of days, and this only came to an end when his father, who happened to be passing by, saw his son sweeping. He confronted the teachers and then, walking away from the school holding Om Prakash's hand, he said loudly for all them to hear, "You are a teacher, so I am leaving now, but remember this much, master, we'll study right here. in this school, and not just him, but there will be more coming after him. When people are treated unequally, the dignity is violated. The dignity of Om Prakash Valmiki was violated because of the way in which he was treated. By picking on him and making him sweep the school because of his caste, Valmiki's schoolmates and teachers hurt his dignity badly and made him feel as if he was less than equal to all other students in the school. Being a child, Valmiki could do very little about the situation that he was in. It was his father who, on seeing his son sweep, felt angry by this unequal treatment and confronted the teachers. Okay, children, thank you. I will continue my lesson in next class.